Welcome back to Half the Battle. I'm your host, as always, Daniel Levi, and joining me now is UFC featherweight Rick Glenn. Rick, welcome to Half the Battle.
Hey, thanks for having me.
Oh, the pleasure's all mine. So, man, a lot of hardcore fans have known about you for a while, but do you feel like you needed that signature performance in the UFC for everyone else to know about Rick Glenn?
Yeah, for sure. It's a much-needed performance. I'm glad I got to put everything together.
Did you expect the fight to be that one-sided?
Yeah, honestly, you know, I expected to finish him. It should have been finished. Unfortunately, I didn't get the finish. I don't know what's going on. My last three or four fights have gone to decision, unfortunately. And, you know, I was, you know, almost at like 100% finish rate with my wins. But, you know, it definitely should have been finished, I thought. And moved out to California, trained with Team Alpha Male, so I'm part of the team now. And, you know, it's you know, a lot better for my career to get work in with those guys that are my size. You know, over the years, I've trained with heavier people, and I'm a little bit quicker now. Yeah, loving California, and the training out there is amazing.
Well, you know, on paper, it says that you didn't finish that fight, but everyone that watched it knows that that fight was finished, man. So as the person that was actually inside the UFC's octagon, you know, knowing that you fought plenty of fights, over 20 fights in your career, was that fight finished?
Yeah. You know, he was playing the ref pretty well. The ref would say, "You got to defend yourself, do something, I'm going to stop it, whatever." And he would just flop just enough for me to readjust. And then, you know, the ref would, I guess, consider him flopping around. You know, him fighting back. And my wife and I actually just watched the fight again this morning before we hit the road. I only watched the whole thing once, so I, you know, looked over it again and kind of critiquing my stuff. You know, win or lose, I'm going to critique myself and work on things. But yeah, there was a few times, especially in the third round, it could have been stopped multiple times.
I know you're a competitor and you'll fight until the job is done, but did you at all feel bad whooping his ass like that?
No, I mean, he was taking it. He was in there. I know what could happen to me. You know, unfortunately, that's a part of what we do. Afterwards, you know, I did feel a little bad. But he's the one that continued his corner. You know, they could have thrown in the towel. The ref, it's kind of hard to put all the blame on the ref. You know, there's other people involved in it, obviously. But yeah, afterwards, it just felt unnecessary. I don't like to even be associated with, you know, a bad call like that. Unfortunately, people do die in the sport. Not often, but it could be, you know, after a beating like that, you know, he went to the hospital and, you know, there's a good chance that he, you know, could have died from the ref not stopping it. So it sucks to just be even associated with that shit.
Well, I mean, thank God he's going to live to fight another day and he's going to be perfectly okay. But I got to know from your perspective, man, is the corner more to blame or is the ref more to blame?
I say the ref. Yeah, the ref.
Yeah, I agree with you there, man. Now, you mentioned in your post-fight that you wanted Calvin Kattar next, and tell us the origin of that rivalry.
It's just, you know, I got one more fight in my contract. I'm ready to break into the top 10 guys, you know, higher ranked guys. I want to finish my contract out and be a really good opponent to fight. It looks like he has a good fight. Good boxing. Sorry, I was just getting some echo on my phone. But yeah, he has good boxing, good striking. Be a good matchup for the fans, I think. And it'd be nice to get the win back for Team Alpha Male. He fought Andre Feely on short notice and, you know, snuck away with the decision. And it'd be nice to get that one back for us. And it'd be a good one. You know, obviously I want to fight him, period. But, it'd be a good matchup.
Is there something about that matchup stylistically that you like, or is it purely that you want to get vengeance for your teammate?
It's pretty even, I guess, evened out, you know, good matchup. I want to get the win back for the team.
Makes sense, man. So how do you feel about your career progression, man? Because it almost seems like your career got, I don't want to say a second win, but people are finally starting to truly appreciate what Rick Land brings to the table.
Yeah, I think you got a second win. You know, before I signed to the UFC, I was kind of doubting my chances of even getting in. I've been fighting for over 11 years now, and I was a World Series fighting champ, lost a belt to Palmer. We're teammates now. So it's awesome to be working with him. And I asked to leave World Series in hopes to go to the UFC, and then I had two fights outside of any major promotion, you know, regional stuff. And we were hitting up Sean Shelby, and he was telling us, you know, they're full, you know, roster's full, whatever. It didn't seem like they were too interested at the time. And, yeah, so I was working a full-time job at Costco in the tire center as a backup supervisor, you know, making decent money for what I thought, I guess, for, you know, a career that you don't have to go to school for, and good benefits, blah, 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 and easy work. So I was kind of looking at that like, all right, you know, the Costco thing might, you know, I might have to stick with that and, you know, put the fighting on the back burner, because I went from making decent money with World Series to regional money, you know, like nothing. I'm breaking even for even taking off work to take the fights. And then I got a short notice call to fight Dunham. And, you know, of course I jumped on the opportunity for that, anything to get my foot in the door for the UFC. And, you know, I wasn't training like I should have been, obviously. And, you know, luckily got the fight of the night bonus. Was able to leave my job, and now I'm reinventing myself and rededicating myself to the sport. And I pack my lunch in the morning, go to work, and, definitely loving life.
Well, you mentioned how you had to take this job, but now you're in the UFC. You got a fight of the night bonus. You have a winning record. Do you feel like you're in the prime of your career, Rick?
No, I'm not in the prime yet. I'm just scratching the surface. I think there's a lot of little kinks I've had to work out, you know, bad habit stuff. And, we're just scratching the surface, I think.
Oh, wow. So what can we expect from Rick Glenn in the next year or two?
More wins, you know, hopefully some finishes, definitely breaking into the top 10. Within the next year, or within a year, I should say. And then, you guys know the end goal, obviously get the belt. That's, you know, that's everyone's goal, or should be, from day one. I've visualized that from, you know, the first day I even thought about fighting. And so when I did get the, It wasn't a surprise to me. It was just a matter of time. I knew what I had to do, and eventually over time, I'm finally.
So last thing I want to ask you, Rick, and I'll get you out of here on this, man. So working with Team Alpha Male, obviously it's been paying dividends. Was that the best that you felt inside the octagon, that last one there with Gavin Tucker?
Yeah, definitely best I felt. Working with Team Alpha Male has helped huge. Love it out there.
Well, that's good to hear. Rick, thank you so much for taking the time to speak with me right here, right now on Half the Battle. It's been a pleasure as always. Let the audience know where they can follow you on social media and any message for the fans. Go ahead, man.
Yeah, thank you guys for tuning in. You guys are just, seeing a little bit of what's to come, just scratching the surface. And, check me out, Rick the Gladiator Glenn, Instagram, Twitter, Facebook. Thank you.